prayer with me as I invoke the presence of God in our midst. Dear Heavenly Father, we come, oh God, in recognition of your perfect Father. Thank you, Father, for the perpetuation of our sins, oh God. And we pray, oh God, for each and every one that is here tonight, Father. Notice, say, Father, that they're here. We pray, oh God, for each voice, Father, that is represented here, Lord, as we lift up your name in praise and song, oh God. We pray, oh God, for our extended family as well, Lord, wherever they be at this time, Lord. We pray, oh God, that everybody throughout this nation, Lord, show their appreciation, Lord, and praise in your name. We thank you, oh God, and we pray, oh God, for the musicians tonight, Lord, to be with them and with the director. And we know that on their way, Father, and keep them safe in our home. Let's be praying in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
the Sharon Gospel Choir and Friends.
Yeah.
We thank God for our friends for having us. And we're just so grateful to just be able to even minister to give God all the praise. And that's what we want to do. And so we just want to welcome you. We want you to feel at home. We like to say at Sharon that this is a place where the arms of Christ are always open. And that means that this is your home too. We want to make you feel welcome. And it's okay to clap. It's okay. We're going to have some narration, so it may feel like calm. But you can praise the Lord. You can clap your hands. We believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And yes, I said Holy Ghost, right, Pastor? Pastor Collins, we have two gifts that we need to remember this year. This Jesus who came and the Holy Spirit that is still with us. So we're going to celebrate that on tonight. And without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to our pastor, Pastor Kevin Ramey, and Sister Marie Ramey, and they have agreed to narrate the story of Christ for us today. But Pastor's coming at this time with some remarks of his own. Praise God. We hope you feel welcome.
Let God's people say amen.
Amen.
Come on, let God's people say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, praise the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory, hallelujah. Praise be to God. And I'm so thankful that as we come for this wonderful Hallelujah Christ is Born musical concert in honor of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, that we can come. And this is not just a celebration we do during Christmas time. What you just heard on the platform, that's something we do all year round. Come on, say amen. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Because our Christmas is every single day. Amen. Amen. And in this season, we let it all out. Come on, somebody. So somebody who has not had Jesus to be birthed in their hearts can have the opportunity to do that even tonight. Praise be to God. And as Sister Linda Foxworth welcomes you here to the Sharon Seventh Day Adventist Church, I am so happy to be able to just echo that and thank you, my wife and I, that you have come this evening. Praise be to God.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came to her and said,
Hail, you are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women.
And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her,
Fear not, Mary, for you have found a favor with God. And behold, you shall conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her,
The Holy Spirit shall come upon you, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow you. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of you shall be called the Son of God. For with God nothing shall be impossible.
And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid. Be it unto me according to your word. And the angel departed from her.
Amen.
the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When, as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found the child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying,
Joseph, son of David, fear not to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
Now all this was done so that what that might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying,
Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us.
Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and he took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
Thank you.
there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. All went to be taxed, everyone into his own city.
And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary his espoused wife, being great with child.
Oh,
would have thought that heaven's greatest gift could be wrapped up in a little baby in a barn, in a feeding trough in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago? But that's exactly what we have. Heaven's greatest gift wrapped up in a baby in a barn in Bethlehem. So great was this gift that the very angels themselves appeared to men in the fields, crying out, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards all." They understood what the gift was about. Salvation touched earth that night. Isn't it a shame if someone leaves that gift unopened and under the tree? We exist solely to tell others about that gift. Because if they don't know, we have failed. We have got to tell everyone, and I mean everyone, about the gift that heaven gave us. That is why we collect it all. It is not to enrich ourselves, but it is so that we can tell others about Jesus Christ. I'm going to ask everyone to stand with me. That's to your feet. Bow your heads. I'm going to say a blessing on this offering. Then we're going to just go past by the table one time and collect. But for now, bow your heads. Father, you gave us everything in Jesus. We would hold nothing back from you. Teach us to give as you gave, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. So can I have that side can sit down. I'm going to ask this side to remain standing. So that side, you sit down. This side, you can just turn towards the wall.